Hello everyone. This is Lincoln, the channel for Higher Self. Welcome to the Satsang with the Self video series. This is the 21st video in the Higher Self Guided Personal Transformation mini-series. This will be the second to last video that I'll record as part of this series. In the Higher Self Guided Personal Transformation mini-series, we examined all parts of the spiritual awakening process. We began by starting at the deepest part of ourselves and then worked successively through the layers of our being out into the physical world. The first video began with pure, empty consciousness, that original foundation of awareness that we are for eternity. And the recent video, released last week, taught us about the energies of the physical world and how they interact with our own physical being. These are the energies of earth, water, fire, and air. Throughout this Higher Self Personal Transformation mini-series, you've been instructed in different ways to bring change into yourself. We began at the deepest layer, and then work through the mind, teaching you how to create new thoughts, teaching you how to understand the movement of mental energy. And then we went into the emotion, teaching you about your chakra system and the energetic patterns within you. You were instructed how to bring more energy into yourself. And then we moved into the physical body. You were taught how to relax it, how to nourish it properly, and how to live with it more effectively within this physical world. And then finally, you were taught about the physical world, the different mental, emotional, and physical energies that exist within the world around you, and how these external experiences change your internal experience. The one theme that runs throughout the entire mini-series is that we are creators of change. We exist as the foundation of ourselves as this formless, empty, open awareness. There is no change within that deepest place because there are no forms. We are the space, the emptiness, the container, that clear light of consciousness that is experiencing reality. And within this clear light of consciousness manifests all the forms of experience. These forms are forever in a state of continuous change. In the physical world, we have the experience of the senses. In the emotional world, we have the energy frequencies related to the chakras. In the mental world, we have that original creative intelligence. And flowing through all these, we have the experience of creative energy. As we exist as this formless awareness, we are always experiencing and interacting with forms that are changing. In this mini-series, you were guided how to bring more of your spiritual self into your mind, body, and emotions to create change. Often during our lives, change happens to us. In fact, this is what karma points to. The word karma is most accurately translated from Sanskrit into English to mean change. Often we believe that karma is what we do comes back to us, or it is stored impressions and memories and identifications within us. These are more of the modern day expansions upon this original term. In the beginning, karma simply meant change. And the teachings of karma were helping us to understand that we live in a constant state of change. The teachings also pointed to the cause and effect relationships of everything. And so there is an endless flow of change as the forms of manifest experience, and we are the formless consciousness experiencing these changing forms. In this mini-series, you are taught to guide this process of change. Existing within you are patterns of idea and emotion and physical formations. These patterns hold in place continual repeating changes. And so we think the same way throughout our lives. We repeat the same thoughts. We repeat the same emotional experiences. We repeat the same physical experiences. And so we're stuck in patterns of familiar change. Everything is changing, but it's as if we're going in circles during our lives. In fact, you may have seen this with yourself. You may have noticed that your mind repeats the same thoughts during your meditations. Often we need to meditate to begin to watch these patterns of thinking. Usually we're not conscious of them because the thoughts are controlling us during our lives. You may have noticed that many of your friendships or relationships are giving you the same inner emotional experiences. You may attract the same type of romantic partner again and again and again, and you may not understand why. You may have the same reaction to similar situations. You may always be in a working environment that causes you to feel the same way. Likewise, you may have repeating physical health problems. Or you may have an attraction to being in a certain type of physical environment, and you keep seeking out that environment again and again. And so everything is changing, but often within us, we choose to select fixed patterns within these changing forms. We feel comfortable, we feel safe and secure in these fixed patterns. During this mini-series, you have been guided to consciously break free from these patterns. In fact, that is why you most likely sought out spirituality in the beginning. You were not completely happy with your life. Maybe there was suffering within it, and you wanted to be free from the suffering. Maybe there was just boredom and nothing exciting because the same experiences were happening again and again, and so you wanted something new and different. Regardless, every desire we have as human beings is to create change. And often, spirituality is a dynamic process to create an entirely different human experience. As we create change in our lives, we often start to experience resistance or discomfort because of the change. Often spiritual teachings, especially those from ancient societies, never talked openly about these experiences of suffering or resistance or confusion that arise on the spiritual path. In fact, most ancient spiritual systems only talked about the heights of realization and the grandeur of the energies and the magnificence of different beings that you'll meet. In many ways, spirituality was presented in a one-sided fashion, giving you all the good aspects and ignoring all the challenges that arise. Please understand that I use the term challenges not in a negative fashion, but actually in a very positive manner, because it is through our challenges that we learn and grow.